2014 has been a fantastic year for science and pop culture. We've had movies about Alan Turing and Stephen Hawking and interstellar travel, but 2014 has also been a fantastic year in real science. We've uncovered some of the biggest dinosaurs ever and landed a robot on a space rock moving Mach 100. Here are my top five science stories of 2014. Number five is an incredible discovery that might turn out to be nothing at all. In spring, a team of researchers running the BICEP, or Background Imaging of Extragalactic Polarization Experiment, published results finding gravitational waves rippling through the cosmic microwave background radiation, or the afterglow of the Big Bang. The results, which would basically prove that inflation occurred in the early universe, were heralded as one of the biggest discoveries of this century. Unfortunately, recently the team behind the data concluded that cosmic dust may have tampered with and ultimately invalidated those results. Star stuff got in the way. For number four, all I have to say is that we made a paralyzed man walk again. In a world first, researchers have enabled a man whose spine was partially severed by a knife attack to walk again. The doctors did it by taking cells from the man's nose, which allowed nerve pathways to grow again, and injected these cells around the injury site. Then they took nerve tissue from the man's ankles and closed the gap. In 3 months, his thigh was putting on muscle again, and in 2 years, he was walking using a frame. Amazing. The number three story is that we found the biggest dinosaurs ever. Just look at these bones. These are the bones of possibly the largest dinosaurs to ever live, belonging to a group called the Titanosaurs. The first of these dinos discovered this summer doesn't have an official name yet, but it may have weighed as much as 14 African elephants and stood as tall as a seven-story building. The second dinosaur, dubbed Dreadnoughtus, may not have weighed as much as the first, but because its bones were in such a good condition when it was found, it is officially the largest land animal whose weight can be accurately calculated. Here's a chart for some perspective. At number two, the European Space Agency landed on a comet. Just last November, the Rosetta mission to land a robot on Comet 67P succeeded, returning data to us that we've never seen before. It's amazing because the Rosetta mission took place over a decade and traveled 6 billion kilometers just to get to a comet that was moving 135,000 kilometers per second to return data to tell us about the formation of our solar system. Finally, my top science story is kind of depressing, but it's important. The debate is over on climate change. Adding to the building consensus, another study this year put the likelihood that human emissions are driving global warming at 99.9%. This is critical because not only are we certain that climate change is happening, we are certain that it's primarily our fault. The science is in. Now that we know the source of the problem, we owe it to the only home we've ever known to come up with a solution. That means taking action. To quote Carl Sagan, we can do science, and with it, we can improve our lives. Each year, we reduce our ignorance of the universe just a bit, learn which questions are actually worth asking, and push humanity towards knowing what we actually don't know. This year has been a fantastic step forward in that regard, and next year, we are poised to learn even more. Why? Because science. Want more science? Check out my last video on New Year's resolution psychology. Click to subscribe for more videos, and if you have any comments or questions, hit me up in the comment section below. Thanks!